Assalamu alaikum, guys. In India, the biggest news that has been coming out, that's been getting worldwide coverage, are the farmers' protests. And in a free and fair country, protests are a part and parcel of that lifestyle choice. But not in India. They have now become like a collective mob. And anyone who speaks against the government is seen as not only unpatriotic, but they're seen as a Muslim.
The weight of office truth is on the
There is such hate against the minority Muslims that are there that it's just become an unhealthy obsession and a mentality. Now, the world has been ignoring it, but now the cancer of Indian Hindu extremism is now making its way out of the country. What do I mean? Just a day or two ago, Rihanna posted on her Twitter something in solidarity of the farmers in India.
Brace yourself.
And rather than people appreciating the fact that she even gives a damn about the issue, they have now been spamming her, bullying her, just full on troll mode on her. To the people of India, they just couldn't fathom why somebody would speak against their country, because it's just become like a gang mentality.
How dare somebody speak against our gang? We must go full on attack mode.
And it's this sort of mentality that the Muslims have been complaining about. But you know what the Indians did? Because they couldn't fathom the fact that she's spoken against them, they went on Google and they Googled her religion, assuming that she was a Muslim. Why? Because she's criticized a policy of the government? But isn't that part and parcel of the democracy? Well, it's not really a democracy, but you guys claim it is, that you guys are part and parcel of. Apparently not. And then I think it was like half a day later, the global warming activist Greta Thunberg, she tweeted, "This girl's just a child, frankly." And India just went ballistic. Yeah, full on troll mode yet again. How dare somebody speak against our country? Modi. He's nicknamed the Butcher of Gujarat, even before he became the Prime Minister. And then afterwards, the people warned other countries that, look, what he's doing in Kashmir, this is very worrying. Yeah, this is very worrying what he's doing. Yeah, and if you look at the mob lynchings, somebody eats beef, that's it. They get publicly beaten to death, kicked in the face, all sorts of stuff. I mean, I could show you guys some clips, but YouTube's a bit funny about that sort of stuff. It just blocks your videos, shadow bans it. So just suffice with me just telling you, there's some videos that I've seen, clips, that are happening in India that honestly, it makes me doubt whether these people are even human beings. After that whole Kashmir thing happened, Muslims are warning people, look, there's something not right about these people. The international community needs to do something. And now you can see the cancer is spreading. And that's what you guys need to understand about these oppressive regimes. And you guys need to be part of any effort that is protecting minorities, yeah? Be it Black Lives Matter movement, yeah? Be it movement against anti-Semitism, be it a movement against Islamophobia, yeah? Because sometimes you think, oh, it's them. But no. When people break through that gate, the people will carry on marching. The momentum is still there. Yeah, and the hate continues. And that's what we say even in these countries like Britain and America, that the governments, now the scapegoat are Muslims. But before Muslims, it was the Catholics, it was the Jews, it was the Blacks. It's always going to be somebody. Yeah, so don't sit back and relax thinking, yeah, it's another group. No, any oppression, you should speak out against, because eventually, if you're a minority, it will come to you. Yeah, so enough of this selective outrage. Yeah, oh, it's terrorism because Muslims have done it. Yeah, Muslims this. No, statistically speaking, we know terrorism is not done mostly by Muslims. You got Buddhist terrorism taking place in Myanmar. In Hindu terrorism taking place in India, you've got Jewish and Zionist extremism taking place in Israel. Yeah, you've got Christian extremism taking place in the United States and in some countries in Africa. Yeah, you've got, of course, Muslim extremism taking place as well. So let's not paint a false picture and lull people into a false sense of security. Yeah, it's just the Muslims, everyone else is fine. No, guys, yeah, we need to understand the reality of what's going on in India, and this is a good wake-up call. Let's leave it there, guys. Until next time, assalamu alaikum.